To be here today, the just after supper time edition. Have you heard this terminology, supper? What's for supper? Popular question that you'll hear out there in the video game. What's for supper? I've asked it many times in my life. I would like to know what is for supper? Haven't had supper yet. Have you had supper yet? Have you asked that to somebody? Have you had supper yet? He's probably eating. Don't call. Why? He's probably eating supper. Sometimes we go to a church supper.
Oh, my God. Yeah.
We go to the suppers. Have you ever been to a supper?
Yeah.
The fire hall has a spaghetti supper. You go down there. Benefit the ladies' auxiliary.
Oh.
Get spaghetti down at the fire hall. You go down there. It's a spaghetti supper. We like to go to pancake breakfasts, if you notice this. We'll go to a pancake... We'll even go to a pancake supper. Have you ever been to a pancake supper? You go, and where you go is you go to the dinner, the supper, the meal, and they serve pancakes. It's like upside down. It's a crazy day. When you go to a pancake supper, it really throws everything off. It kind of gives you a jolt. I think that's why we do it, just to get ourselves thrown off. Where are you going? Pancake supper? Ooh, you are living on the edge. You are living dangerous in your life. Are you kidding me? You're going to throw your equilibrium off. Now calm down and get in line for some more flapjacks. We'll go down there. We'll go down to the VFW and eat. We'll go down there. We'll go down there where the trucks used to be. Had to take the trucks out for bingo. You go down past the fire hall, right? And they got to take the trucks out for bingo. Let's go. We're having bingo tonight. Get those trucks out of here. Get these people in. Get those freaking trucks out of here and set the tables up. Henry, you calling bingo tonight? I sure am. I call it every night. He's kind of like the DJ of the place. You know he gets laid. You know he does. That's Rainsford terminology. Laid. That's what he calls it. I learned that from... Listen to Rains' comedy enough. I listened to one of his albums recently. Picked up some things like that. Yeah, but Henry the bingo caller, he gets laid. There's no question about it. There's Helen over there with her dauber. He's under the B3, and she's like, yeah. Because he's looking good. He's running the show. He's the DJ of the place. You can't tell me he's not going home with some of with someone. Albeit in a walker or some other... So yeah, that all goes on down there at the fire hall. Things that go on at the fire hall, right? That's what goes on there with the VFW, the Veterans of Foreign Wars. That's how you become a member of the VFW. You gotta be a veteran of a foreign war or their guests. See, now I don't have to be a veteran of the foreign war. I just have to be going in there with someone that is. Ask around, hey man, were you overseas in a war? I'm really thirsty. You take me in the VFW? Later on, we'll go down the fire hall for the pancake supper. If you really want to live on the edge, we'll stay late and we'll take the trucks out of there and clean up the supper and we'll have the bingo. And there's your challenge. Go ahead, fire hall, step up and have a pancake supper and followed by bingo. Not separate nights, same night. There you go, pulling double duty down there at the fire hall. And we always have to get these fire trucks on stock because we know that we might catch ourselves on fire. We have placed a safety in. We know that there might be a time that fire gets away from me in my home or around it. We're going to keep people full time We're going to have trucks. We're going to be ready for this because we know it's going to happen. I can't be trusted with fire. And man, we're fascinated with it. Have you noticed this?
Yeah.
So the fire whistle goes off. The people start going, where is the fire? People want to know. They demand to know one thing and one thing only. Where's the fire? We'll go through painstaking search to find out where the fire is. Usually there's a network of people that's all lined up for it. As soon as the whistle goes off, a phone rings. Hey, just about to tell you, it's a car fire down on Route 219. Because they're the person with the scanner. And they get the first information of where the fire is. Did you hear where the fire was? Now, when I was growing up in a small town, when the fire whistle would go off, the local radio station would say, the fire whistle have just gone off. Be right in the middle of Elton John's. Here we are. And Kiki D's number one hit, Don't Go Breaking My Heart. And a guy comes and he goes, the fire whistle has sounded. And everyone in the house goes, shh. This is the moment we've been waiting for. I want to know just as well as you do, where is the fire? And they would announce the fire. It's a car fire, or it's a garage fire. And then you would have to go spring into action and do your job, which is to tell somebody else. Phone lines are jammed. People trying to call each other. There's a car fire on Spruce Street, and our network is jammed up here. I got to make a call. People waiting at phone booths. Come on. I got to make calls. I'm in charge of letting this thing. I haven't been at a phone booth in quite some time. Remember that experience?
Yeah.
Boy, that was back in the day. You can talk about back in the day. Here's how we had it set up. We had these phone booths where you go in and your whole body is encased by this plastic. It's a real small confined space, so it has to be like an accordion-style door. And you shut it, and you're just in this box. If you have not done this, go ahead and do some time travel and travel back to the days where there's a phone booth, or find one somewhere and just get inside it. And then make a call. You go in there, and there's a phone book hanging. It's ready. We're ready. Hey. It's hanging down. Of course, it only takes about a couple of weeks because each person thinks that phone book's their personal property.
And when
they find the page they're looking for and they don't remember, they just rip the one page out. No, they just peel it out one page and let the book dangle.
Yeah.
He's like, what's the chances they're going to look at the L's here? This person needs page 175. So you go into this booth, this box, this big glass case to do your business. You go in there to call somebody, and you're in there talking. People going by, they see you. I'm in this box. I'm in this communicator. It's like the future. You're in this communication box where you're speaking to your somebody that you must speak to via payphones. That's why payphones were so popular for the while, because people have phones, right? But when they want to talk about things they don't want anyone else to hear at home, they go to the payphone. Yeah, I'll talk to you down the payphone, all right? Matter of fact, this is Conference Call America, the payphone edition, where we talk about things that you can only talk about on payphones. Because you got secret business now. I better get my change because I can have the right amount of change. I don't want my secret business being interrupted by me not having enough money here. Now the lady, if that happens, the lady comes on, please deposit some more money, she says. I'm like, are you listening to this whole thing? Like, can you just listen the whole time? Oh my God, you must get a kick out of this. So that'd be a good time. Phone operator. Back in the day, the operators used to have to come on and connect everything. That'd have been a good time. You ever see these old pictures of old switchboards and they're pulling the plugs and they're moving the plugs from one thing to the next? Old time telephone.
Yeah.
What are you on now? Right now, we got some technology out there today, don't we? Probably some people on some Blackberries. There they are. They're feeling good about their life. I'm on a Blackberry. I'm on an upward spiral. Why? I got myself a Blackberry. I said one day if I had a Blackberry, I'd be happy.
Yeah.
Or a slide phone, or the proverbial iPhone. People like the iPhone now. We got to get some people on the iPhone on Conference Call America. Be the first to have an iPhone. I have that. Well, then text it in. Text it in. All right. So you're in the phone booth. You're in there with the change. You put the money in the machine. And the other person on the other line picks up the phone and you have a conversation. Can you imagine? You can talk to somebody just anywhere that has a phone connected to the same wire. And you begin your conversation. That was futuristic at one time. So where are we heading with all this today, people? Well, really nowhere. The point of it was just to have some comedic relief, have a good time, take a little break from the mundane, from the everyday, from the rigmaroles of life. So what do you say? We have the rest of the night of comedic fun. Find everything and look at that. Someone brings you an envelope and say, all right, there's going to be something hilarious on this, and I'm going to find it. And not only going to find it, I'm going to show someone else. How funny it really is. Look at this letter I got. Or whatever my situation is, I'm looking for the comedy because I'm already on a comedic roll and I can see how much more fun life would be if I was laughing at it, if I was pointing at it, if I was joking around about it, than it would be if I was so serious. Studio audience here tonight, you guys have been a great time, that's for sure. So, here's what I learned on Conversations with God today. Everything depends, here's what I heard God say. Everything depends on what you perceive to be the purpose of your life. All right, really good being here. We're gonna do it again tomorrow. Thanks for coming out. Oh, man.